Hi, my name's Tyrone Shum, and thanks so much for visiting Internet Business Path. In today's topic, I just wanted to be able to share with you what tools that I use to be able to outsource my business, to be able to get the programs to do the work that I want them to do. And I've spoken to a few people and also heard from some feedback from a lot of people, and they struggle to actually communicate with their programmers, virtual assistants, or any of their staff that they hire on a full-time or even a contracting basis. And I think the key to it is to be able to communicate exactly what you want to be done. And the best thing to do is to be able to use a particular software or use the right communication tools to be able to communicate with these people. Now, I personally, in my business, I've been using a particular software called Jing, J-I-N-G, which can be found at jingproject.com. This particular software is a software that's been designed by a very, very popular software company called Camtasia. Most of you may have heard of Camtasia Studio before, and it's an absolutely fantastic software. The only difference is between these two is that Camtasia software costs a few hundred dollars to be able to buy, and not everyone can afford to buy a software like that. So a good option is Jing, which is Jing Project, and this is completely free. Now, I want to tell you the first things about Jing and just to give you a quick brief overview of what it is. Firstly, Jing is free, as I've mentioned. Secondly, it allows you to record up to 5 minutes per clip. So hopefully you can actually express to your people that are working for you when you're outsourcing your work within 5 minutes exactly what the task should be. Normally for me, I usually take no more than 2 or 3 minutes to be able to describe a particular task. And the best thing to do is to cut it as short as possible or make it as short as possible. The reason why I say that is because you want to be able to have those steps easy, simple, and straight to the point, because people don't want to go through and hear about 10 different tasks within one particular clip. The next thing I want to also mention too as well is that it automatically creates it in a particular format that's viewable all across the internet. And it's created in a particular format called Flash. Now, Flash is also widely used, and the beauty about this particular thing is once it's converted in Flash for you, you can either have a button which you can click on and upload it automatically to, say, for example, your website, an FTP server, or alternatively, you can use Jing's server, which is also free too, and I think it's located at Screencast, which is screencast.com. But all you have to do is simply sign up an account there, and you'll be able to upload your files up there for free. Now, once the actual particular clip or your task has been created in a video format or screen capture format or whatever you choose to do it in, it will simply copy the exact link of where it's located into your clipboard. And once you've done that, just paste it straight into the email that you need to send off to any of your programmers or VAs or anyone that you've outsourced your work to. So that's really the main reason why I recommend you use Jing. Now, the other thing as well too is I want to give you a brief overview of how to send this work over to any of your outsourcers and to make it as simple and as clear and as easy for them to do. I had previously mentioned make it short, sharp, and concise. That's the first point I want to point out to you. The thing is you want to be able to send the work over to them in multiple tasks, and you want to break, say for example, a huge project down. Say let's create a brand new project that you need to be able to set up a completely brand new website. What you want to be able to do is within this whole project, you want to say to them, look, I want you to create a project with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different requirements. And those 5 different requirements can be broken down into separate tasks. And hopefully it will take you no more than 5 minutes to be able to explain each individual task. That's one thing I want you to do if you're going to be using Jing. The next thing I'd probably recommend as well when you're using Jing as well is to be able to communicate with them via using pictures and also screencast. So when you're actually using the screencast and you've got, say for example, your headphone and your microphone on, you want to be able to use your mouse and point to those exact things that you want to be done. I'll give you an example. When I was creating a particular button and I wanted a particular color and also I wanted a particular style for a particular button, what I did was I had 2 browser windows open. One of the style and the color and the font that I liked, and then another browser window of exactly the shape and also the text that needs to go in there. And simply all I did was describe, I wanted this particular color and that font to go into that particular button. And if you're able to actually create that in a screencast, hopefully your outsourcers will understand. One other thing as well, to make it even more concise and also for your outsourcers to understand, because the last thing you want to do is send something over and they read it or watch your video clip and still don't understand, which I hope you don't have, is just to probably give notes, very brief points. I usually try to put at least or at most three simple points. It may include links to the sites that you want to be able to get them to review. It may be even to, for example, music audio clips that you might want them to download and implement into a particular task that you want to do. Whatever it may be, keep it down to as minimal points as possible and make sure that it's so concise that they can actually follow through step by step. And that's what I've learned from being able to manage and also outsource my work. If you can keep all those things and apply those simple points, I'm pretty sure you won't have a problem communicating to your staff. So this ends this video here, and I do hope that you'll enjoy working with your outsourcers and working with your staff and take away all the information that I've been able to talk to you and share with you today. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback, simply just put it down below, just right down below here, and I'll be able to respond back to you straight away. Have a great day, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video.